Bessemer has been investing successfully in security for decades. There is no doubt that in recent years, cybersecurity has moved from being a niche area to the main stage. Attacks like SolarWinds, Colonial Pipeline, and recently one-fifth of the US beef capacity being completely wiped out by cyber attack on JBS ensure cyber is front and center not only in the Wall Street Journal, but also in every boardroom. While we believe there are more opportunities than ever for Bessemer to generate outsized returns by investing in cybersecurity, it is also a difficult space to navigate. Cybersecurity tends to be overcrowded and valuations creep up very quickly. We want to share with you our most revised thinking about investing in the space. The cyber market is changing at a growing pace. With new security issues constantly arising, the enterprise cyber perimeter becoming more complex, new emerging technologies develop faster than ever, hackers becoming more sophisticated, and regulations trying to keep up with all this. As a result, we constantly see new point solutions come up that address small parts of the security stack. To illustrate, this security landscape only shows a portion of the companies we see. We've recognized a few challenges for the cybersecurity marketplace. Even for experts, this is very confusing. It's difficult for CISOs to distinguish between the different products, and they're overwhelmed by the number of vendors, which all sound very similar. They don't have the time to test and deploy all possible solutions. So the question is not whether a vendor is solving a problem or closing a security gap, but how that problem stacks up against other priorities. Many CISOs are also looking to consolidate solutions and move to broader and more comprehensive security platforms. Yet the legacy players are slow in their product innovation, so they often don't have options for emerging security areas. The way we see it is that the cybersecurity industry is going through its own evolution. CISOs don't have the bandwidth to keep up with all the options. Many legacy companies are not innovating fast enough, and even Gartner and analysts cannot distinguish between the vendors, as these companies all use the same marketing jargon. In fact, even the websites look exactly the same. The implication for startups is that it's not just the best tech solution that wins, but also whoever has the best go-to-market and can rise above the noise. With all these points in mind, we recognize that solutions are often siloed, which is why our team at Bessemer loves to invest in companies that help consolidate and orchestrate them. For example, Axonius, which we first led the Series A in 2019, is an asset inventory management platform that focuses on cybersecurity policies. The elegance of Axonius is that unlike other security solutions, which require to install a probe in the network or agents on the endpoints, Axonius simply consolidates and correlates data from the many other security and IT tools that are already deployed to provide a single view of the entire enterprise. In addition, we first invested in Torque, formerly known as StackPulse, at the seed stage in 2020. Torque's no-code automation modernizes how security and operation teams work with easy workflow building, limitless integrations, and numerous pre-built templates. This allows them to be much more efficient and better use their existing solutions. In the past, few large incumbents like Checkpoint, Palo Alto Networks, Symantec, and Cisco completely dominated the market. The best outcome for a startup was to get acquired by one of these major platforms. Yet the emergence of new categories and the quick pace of change makes it more feasible than ever to build new large independent cybersecurity companies today. We are now seeing new security companies go public and become dominant independent companies. CrowdStrike, Okta, Cloudflare, Zscaler are all examples of new companies that are now among the top 10 largest security companies in the world. This results in much larger potential for investors. With this in mind, we recognize that 2021 brought some of the largest cyber acquisitions to date, including Okta purchasing BVP-funded Auth0 for $6.5 billion. The private market has also followed suit, with cybersecurity companies raising money at a much faster pace than ever before. The combination of larger exit potential and the fierce competition on marketing and talent results in that winners get nominated by investors much earlier and continue to raise huge amounts early on in their journey to outperform competition. This requires us to try to identify winners even at an earlier stage. Israel has also become a powerhouse for cyber, with 31% of global investments in the sector and more than a third of global cyber unicorns coming from Israel. The region has strong and ambitious team, well-crafted playbooks to follow, and more investments in the space. This also means that as investors, we need to stay close and attract the best entrepreneurs early on.
The market is growing and threats are becoming more sophisticated as cybercrimes become institutionalized. Underscoring the severity of the threat, in May of 2021, President Biden released an executive order to improve the nation's cybersecurity amid a wave of ransomware and other cyber attacks against U.S. businesses. He stated that the prevention, detection, assessment, and remediation of cyber incidents is a top priority and essential to national and economic security. Considering this, there are three high-level trends we're following in cybersecurity. The institutionalization of cyber threats. The tools and techniques required to perpetrate an attack have become widely available. The recent surge in ransomware is an example. Criminal organizations now sell ransomware as a service kits, which are promoted and sold on the dark web using the same marketing and sales tactics that legitimate businesses use on the regular web. These solutions can be deployed at scale and make it cost-effective to target not just large enterprises, but also mid-sized organizations and even small businesses that usually lack dedicated security expertise. A shortage of talent in the cybersecurity industry has been a problem for years and leaves many businesses outmanned and vulnerable. The U.S. government estimates there are currently a record 500,000 open jobs in the cybersecurity industry. Digital currencies have made payment easier, faster, and more difficult to trace. TRM Labs monitors digital asset transactions to protect financial institutions from risks like fraud and money laundering. As you can imagine, this investment we made in 2021 sits squarely among our fintech and emerging crypto roadmap and our data privacy and cybersecurity roadmaps. As we mentioned, ransomware is currently the most common attack. In fact, they more than doubled from 2019 to 2020, and they now account for 30% of all cyber attacks. And when we dissect the anatomy of a ransomware attack, it typically breaks down into this type of framework. First, a phishing email tricks employees into opening an attachment or clicking on a link that downloads malicious software. Once access is gained, the attacker uses tools to gather login credentials and spreads laterally throughout the network as it attempts to identify high-value assets such as AWS admin passwords. Then, a hacker encrypts and exfiltrates high-value data such as personally identifiable information, source code, and other critical information. At this point, they demand payment in Bitcoin or another digital currency in exchange for decryption keys and promise not to leak exfiltrated data. Finally, attackers often lurk on the network even after they've been paid. With these vulnerabilities in mind, Bessemer has invested in several areas to address these problems, and we'll call out a few examples here. For example, the first step in avoiding a breach of sensitive customer data is to make sure you know where the data is stored across the enterprise. BigID helps enterprises take inventory of sensitive customer personal information and apply the proper access controls. Another example is Hunters.ai, which is a recent investment. The company can proactively identify threats by leveraging open data sources and the performance of cloud data warehouses to detect indications of compromise in real time. And we have several other portfolio companies working to solve the many issues that arise with ransomware. Centra, which is currently in stealth mode, is an Israeli cybersecurity company tackling data security in the age of cloud. The idea is to connect all of the data sources and provide a single place for the security team to see what data exists and build policies around it. As we look ahead, we have a set of criteria that helps us determine what we invest in and why. We often take what we refer to as a barbell approach, and this means that we aim to invest very early or in late stage growth rounds. We try to avoid the shiny Series A. We always consider the efficiency of the go-to-market motion and ease of deployment, and it's often viewed as important as the product itself. We also prioritize investing in solutions that benefit from ongoing consolidation in the industry or simplify other product categories. As we address new growing categories, we emphasize our commitment to cloud and technologies that sit at the cross-section of development, security, and operations, also known as DevSecOps. In addition, we're prioritizing solutions that support SMBs and mid-market organizations that can't buy best of breed, but still need protection at an affordable price, or industry verticals that have been slower to adopt cyber protection. With all these parameters in mind, we are looking forward to investing in the following three areas. Data is stored in so many locations and it's widely distributed as organizations shift to cloud computing and expand their workforce all over the world. With this in mind, our first area of investment is dedicated to data security, tokenization, and encryption. Next is our focus on vertical-specific security solutions. While cyber spend is a critical component of every company's budget, it varies widely by industry, with internet and software companies leading the way in terms of overall percentage of IT spend on security. We think that other industries that deal with sensitive consumer data, such as retail and healthcare, will need to increase their spend on cybersecurity to better comply with regulations and avoid costly fines for data breaches. We also see opportunity in industries that have historically been offline, such as utilities and manufacturing, as they start to connect more devices to the cloud. As critical infrastructure begins to run on the cloud, it becomes ever more important to have proper cybersecurity solutions in place. This is why we invested in Clarity in 2016. The company's platform provides real-time monitoring of anomalies in industrial operational networks, helping to protect critical infrastructure like water treatment facilities and electrical grids. And finally, while there has been innovation across the stack, the number one way hackers infiltrate an organization's sensitive data store is by doing so through the employee base. Phishing continues to be the most popular entry point for ransomware attacks, and better protections are needed to prevent employees from clicking on malicious links. This is why we invested in CoFence back in 2016, an anti-phishing and security training platform. And we're eager to back the next generation of security training, awareness, and email security vendors. With these areas in mind, we recognize at Bessemer that innovation in cybersecurity should strive to outpace the attempts of criminal hacker groups. As phishing exploits become more sophisticated, there are opportunities to build new tools and platforms to protect people, enterprises, and world governments as the digital and data economy becomes more complex.